directed who? Particularly the newly elected president and the executive of Muta of America. It is my pleasure to congratulate you on your victory and to wish you well in your new assignment, which is very challenging and which has come at a crucial time to life of the key people in the world. There are three things which I wish to talk about very briefly. First, we cannot overflow the issue of identity. Every group of people in the world will rise or sink if they have or lack identity. But yesterday, the emphasis was on language. Language is just one aspect of identity. Much more important are other aspects like relationship within the group. Recently, one disturbing trend is coming up in Thailand and is something we should consider. There are some key people who are thinking the society should be turned into a hierarchical one, where there will be classes, some down, some up. This is creeping in slowly. As students of society, we are studying this and we are very concerned. God created the two people equal. We can respect people on basis of achievement, on basis of their age, on basis of the position they occupy. But when you begin to feel superior to a fellow team, you're walking the wrong road. Happily, you are in a country which emphasizes this aspect of social relations so much. So we expect a lot of this example from those of you living in the United States. This is the world's best example for democracy. Today, our country is facing the crisis of democracy. We expect vibrant ideas from you to help us resolve this issue within Thailand and beyond. In this respect, I wish to congratulate Muta for the role they played in 2001 when Thailand was under invasion by the Nigerian army. You rose up to the occasion to give this unfortunate incident a challenge, and you exposed the evil plan against the people. And I'm telling you, this was no small contribution towards saving us. So, because you live in the United States, your access to the world media is easier, and this is a very powerful tool. Please learn how to use this privilege for our greater good. The second issue I want to talk about is your relationship with us at home, particularly with the government and your fellow team people. It is not clear to me what you want to do in this respect. Do you wish to take resources from Makurdi and spend them in the United States, or do you wish to take funds from here back to Makurdi? It's a very serious question, and I want to be giving much thought. If you have read Antiquus Odysseus, you discover that they left Nigeria to come to the United States to acquire knowledge to be empowered to serve their fellow man back home. Your executive must never be under the illusion or entertain the idea that you depend on the Benue State Treaty. If you do that, you are failed. That will be capital flight. Roll your sleeve, do the manual work. Use your brain, make the money. We want you to make large donations to causes at home. The chief judge mentioned this in passing, but it's a very serious point. If you know that $1 translates to 119 or 120 naira, you'll know that if you remit $10 to your parents in the village, you empower them correctly. But $10 say you can buy them and think you have done nothing. But $10 in a tea village on a sustainable period of time, you empower that village. So please make it a to remit money on a regular basis to a cause, to your family, to friends. What you consider little here is a lot there. Lastly, the global challenge. People living in the United States, as I've said earlier on, are very privileged people. The amount of information you get, the amount of communication facilities at your disposal are immense and are the envy of the rest of the world. What I want you to do in this regard is to harness this and use this to affect world causes. There must be a team voice when United Nations issues of habitat are being discussed. There should be a team perspective on poverty alleviation. There should be a team perspective on interracial marriages, because we're in a position to say something, and we should say it from an informed position, from a position of ethnic identity that is well established and grounded. If we do this, within a very short time, the two people will have a new image in the world. British colonial history, our Second Republic, First Republic politics, gave us a negative image of people who just want to fight and fight their neighbors. Unfortunately for us today, the two people are very, very generous. Let me give you an example. In Benue State, there are 23 local governments. The chief occupy 14 of those local governments. If government there were to be taking a rational approach to sharing resources, chief should get 2/3 of whatever is going and 1/3 for the rest of the state. That would be fair, wouldn't it? Because if I'm building 23 hospitals, as I tell my class in Makurdi, hospitals are for human beings. You have 14 local governments, you give them one hospital per local government, which is the policy Gombong followed in Benue Plateau State. People who got 9 cannot complain. On what basis can they complain? But today, our brothers and sisters in the Benue Valley have pushed us to the wall to be ashamed that we are many and to be quest to give them more than they are entitled. These are global issues of justice and fairness, and we want you from here to help us resolve debates such as this. To end, I wish to thank everybody for participating in this conference. It was a very successful one, and I wish everybody genuine. Thank you.